select alphas, conditioned to believe without knowing and to know without believing, you have been chosen to view the surrogate revelations and synthetic mysteries upon which all perfect and placebic belief is founded. Here before you are sacred teletime plex relics of the sanctified life, thought, and holy works of our Ford, from whose divine inspiration came the ultimate perfection of the endless assembly line, which has given us the ultimate, endless, perfect happiness of more things, for more wants in perfect balance, with more wants for more things.
We'll be right back. place out there for graft, or greed, or lies, or compromise with human liberties.
To cut them school programs. Every time y'all vote to cut them funds to the job programs. What the fuck? How a young man gonna take care of his financial responsibilities working the motherfucking Burger King? He ain't.
Thank you. it, isn't it? More or less accurate. So the educational system is supposed to train people to be obedient conformists, not think too much, do what you're told, stay passive, don't cause any crisis in democracy, don't raise any questions, and so on. That's basically what the system is about. Even the fact that the system has a lot of stupidity in it, I think, has a function. You know, it means that people are filtered out for obedience. If you can guarantee lots of stupidity in the educational system, you know, like stupid assignments and things like that, you know that the only people who will make it through are people like me and like most of you, I guess, who are willing to do it no matter how stupid it is, because we'll want to go to the next step, you know. So you may know that the assignment is idiotic, the guy up there bag, but you'll do it anyway, because that's the way you get the big class. Well, there are people who don't know. There are people who say, I'm not doing anything. Those people are called behavioral problems, or something like that. They end up in the principal's office, or in the streets, or selling drugs, or whatever. And all of this is a technique for selection for obedience. Serious problems. Yeah. We think of Japan as
Thank you. And it is from our inspired creator of the Model T that we derive our blessed sign of the T.
Glory be great.
Let us now repeat the catechism. Community.
Community.
Identity.
Identity.
Stability.
Stability.
Fourth blessing. I am Mustafa Mond, assistant controller to her four chief, Nixona Vic, Western World Controller, and I have been assigned to show you certain selected histobunk highlights from the past.
But everything is perfect now, and everything will always be perfect. So what does it matter what things were like when it wasn't perfect?
Excellent point, but quite misguided. Exposing future stability monitors, such as yourself, to the imperfection of the past is, of course, part of the perfection of the present. Centuries ago, in primitive times, before the dawn of civilization, there were things that would be inconceivable to us today. Such things as poverty. Although there was actually land and food in abundance, some starved, because unlike our perfect society, they were unable or unwilling to balance population and consumption. But sometimes, too much of one, or too little of the other, the result? Disease. And rather than eradicate the source of disease, as we have done, the superstitious primitives continue to rely upon a quite useless class of technicians called doctors. Violence, which the ancients actually appear to have enjoyed and reveled in. While we have been perfectly conditioned to want only what we have, only what we want, and are, therefore, always happy. The uncivilized ancients were prey to destructive emotions, such as ambition, hate, and love, which, of course, always led to violence.